Distance. So today we are going to study one important numerical from Young's double slit experiment. So let us see the question. What is the question? In YDSE, YDSE means Young's double slit experiment. If a glass slab of thickness T and refractive index mu is placed in the path of one of the interfering beam of light, then how the fringe width will change? So that means you have seen the Young's double slit experiment in which there are two light waves. Now suppose if we place one glass slab or any obstacle in the path of one of the interfering beam of light, then how will the fringe width will change? So that is the question. So to solve this question, we have to understand one of the important concept of optical path difference. So here in the diagram, you can see that light waves are passing. So there is a glass slab, and above the glass slab, there is no medium is present. So what is the path covered by the light wave in the absence of any medium? So that is given by refractive index of air multiplied by the distance covered. So distance, you can see in the diagram, it is equal to small letter t, because t is the thickness of the glass slab, right? So path covered by the light in air, we can say it is equal to 1 into t. Now in the presence of the medium glass slab, how the path will change? So path covered in the glass slab will be refractive index of the glass slab, that is mu, multiplied by distance covered, so that is given by t. Then what is the path difference? So path difference will be mu t minus 1 into t, so that will be given by mu minus 1 into t. So this delta x is known as the optical path difference. So this concept is very important. We are going to apply this one here. So again, I am telling you, so what is the concept? That if the light waves passes through air, then the path covered is given by refractive index of air multiplied by the distance. And if the light wave is passing through a medium, that is glass slab, then it will be refractive index of glass slab mu multiplied by the distance covered. So then how to find the path difference? This is simply that subtraction of two path covered. So that will come out mu minus 1 into t. Now let us see how we can apply this concept here. So here you can see the Young's double slit experiment, where two light waves coming out from the two coherent sources of light S1 and S2. Now we have placed the glass slab on the first interfering medium, as you can see in the diagram. So how the path difference will change? So delta x will become S2p minus S1p, plus it will be extra optical path difference that just now we have seen. So that is given by mu minus 1 into t. So like this we get, so the path difference delta x will come out S2p minus S1p minus within bracket mu minus 1 into t. Now again for central maxima, what are the condition for path difference? We know that is given by delta x equal to 0. So that already we have seen in Young's double slit experiment calculation. Then we can write simply S2p minus S1p will be equal to mu minus 1 into t. So from here, again, the path difference S2p minus S1p, we know that is equal to d sine theta. And again, sine theta can be written as x by capital D. So this calculation, you can see in the Young's double slit experiment part, where we have seen the derivation of this. So in the derivation part, we get all the calculation that S2p minus S1p equal to d sine theta, and how sine theta equal to x by d. So there you can see. So from here, x will be how much? Capital D by small d multiplied by mu minus 1 into t. And from here, we can calculate number of fringes that are shifted. So that will be given by x by beta. So if we put the value of beta, that is the fringe width lambda capital D by small d, then we get x by beta will be mu minus 1 into t divided by lambda. So these are the number of fringes which are shifted. So here, what will happen? The fringes will shift because of the presence of this glass slab. So I think you have understood today's lecture. Thank you.